Does my three-dimensional compass system make sense? I'm developing a fantasy setting where people can go to other planes, universes, that are not made of mostly empty space, like our universe is. Instead, you have universes made mostly, but not entirely, of earth, water, or gas. Gravity works differently on these planes, so you don't have all this matter collapsing in on itself. They're also not as big as our universe, though they're suspected to be larger than our solar system, at the very least. In order to facilitate navigation in settings without stars or easily visible landmarks, I've decided that there's some kind of magical field that is detectable with a special compass. This magical field, when measured correctly, indicates a center point to the plane, four horizontal points north, south, east, west, and two vertical points up, down. But this is where I'm running into a problem. I need a simple, easy to understand naming convention for the up to down directions on this three-dimensional compass system. If a character says, we need to go north, the reader automatically understands what he means. However, if the character is indicating a direction that is also on the z-axis, using terms that sound like at 45 degrees might be confusing and, more importantly, disorienting. I need my characters to be able to indicate they want to go not only north, but north and up or down. I believe I may have a naming convention figured out, one which I think might sound natural for my characters to speak, but while it makes sense to me, I need feedback from other people to make sure that it works. So, here's how the system works. The center of the compass is the origin point, O, on the Cartesian coordinate system. Remember, the magical field indicates a central point. On the X, Y axes, the cardinal directions are the same as a conventional compass rows. North, 0 degrees equals 360 degrees, east, 90 degrees, south, 180 degrees, west, 270 degrees. The z-axis has two points of simply call, up, 0 degrees equals 360 degrees, and down, 180 degrees. When characters describe specific degrees on the z-axis, they don't use terms like north or south. Instead, 45 degrees is upward, while 135 degrees is downward. Thus, going north on a 45 degrees angle is going upward north, while going north and down at a 135 degrees angle is downward north. The same applies to all the other cardinal and intercardinal points on the compass, i.e., upward south, downward east, upward northwest, downward southeast, etc. As for the points of 22.5 degrees and 67.5 degrees on a vertical compass, the equivalents of north-northeast and east-northeast on a horizontal compass rows, the terms high and low are used. So, going north at a 22.5 degrees is going high upward north. Going north at a 67.5 degrees angle is going low upward north. The same applies to the points of 112.5 degrees and 157.5 degrees from up on the z-axis, which would be the equivalents of east-southeast and south-southeast on a horizontal compass rows. Thus, going north on a 112.5 degrees angle is high downward north, and going north on a 157.4 degrees angle is low downward north. Does this system make sense, or is it too confusing to understand?
Keep it simple. Use the cardinal directions as normal, then vertical direction based on what fraction of a right angle your directional vector is. Note that this is completely independent of what you use for units, whether your culture has divided a circle into 360 degrees or 100 units or some other interval. Northeast up half is heading northeast going upward at half a right angle, 45 degrees. South-southwest down two-thirds is heading south-southwest going downward at 60 degrees. East flat or east up down none or simple east means heading straight east at the current altitude. Up full and down full means straight up and down, obviously. A cardinal heading would be pointless, but could be included if, for instance, you wanted to be facing a specific direction for whatever reason. If you can imagine a helicopter, then an order like west down full 100 meters would mean hovering and descending 100 meters straight down, facing west. The advantage of this type of system is that it's easily adapted to numerical values if your culture and the technology permits, as should be obvious. 315 down 30 is, assuming a 360-unit circle, a heading of northwest 315 degrees descending at an angle of 30 degrees. In the older system it would be northwest down one-third.